We return to the hotline in the number 30 car this weekend in the NASCAR Nationwide Series Royal Purple 200 at Darlington. Jason Leffler. Jason, top of the morning.
What's happening?
Hey, Jason.
What's going on, guys?
How are you?
Good.
We just got word that the Grand Am Series is putting a $25,000 bounty on the Ganassi team for someone to beat them. What would you think about something like that coming over here to the world of NASCAR? I mean, you know that whole bounty thing from the world of your short track days. What about over here in NASCAR?
That's a great idea. I mean, it's funny. We were doing a media event at Chicagoland, I guess Monday, and it was Ricky Stenhouse and Justin Allgaier and myself. And, you know, we all kind of come from open wheel. And we were saying that NASCAR Nationwide needs to come up with a bounty to beat Kyle Busch. I think it would be great, a great media play, great publicity, and good for everybody else involved. So I think that's a great idea.
Well, why don't we lump Carl and Brad and all the Cup guys into that as well?
Well, we might as well, but I mean, you know, as dominant as Kyle is, you know, he's the villain right now. So everybody needs to go after him. But, yeah, I mean, that's a great idea. That's cool. That goes back to short track racing and that's funny because we were just talking about that, but that's a cool way to race, you know. Got to get that guy.
Have you ever raced in a race that has had a bounty on a driver
or you?
No, but there used to be a bounty on my hero Dean Thompson that raced at Ascot Park. He won so much, and I know my father-in-law Bob East got the bounty at the ditch there in Memphis, Tennessee, for beating Sammy Swindell back in the early 80s or late 70s. So, you know, it's pretty cool. I think it's a great way to get the fans excited and everybody excited.
I know you mentioned you were here in my backyard on Monday at Chicagoland Speedway. I didn't get a chance to run down there and say hi to you guys. But what do you think about that, racing here at Chicagoland, and you're going to be the spotlight race there, the Nationwide Series, in a standalone event on June 4th?
Yeah, that's really cool. I mean, I didn't know that until I showed up. I just figured it was a doubleheader, and we showed up to do the media, and it was a good surprise to know that we're going to be the only race there. It's exciting, you know, a Saturday night race, and Cup Boys will all be in Kansas, and Trucks will be in Kansas, and we'll be at Chicagoland. I mean, it's pretty cool. I mean, we're used to standalone events, obviously, at some short tracks, but not at a venue like Chicagoland Speedway. So that's really cool in that market, and look forward to going there for sure.
Let's talk a little bit about Richmond. 10th place finish last Friday night. Your thoughts there, that top 10 performance there for you guys?
I don't know if it was a top 10 performance. We finished 10th. We ran about 20th all day. So Addie Pardue and the guys, they are we've narrowed a lot of stuff down with our race cars in general. And so hopefully I think we got a lot better car going into Darlington this weekend than we did there. And Eddie and we had great pit stops. Eddie called a great race. And with all the shaking up that went on at the end of the race, we ended up 10th. So, you know, sometimes you just got to make pit calls and take a chance. And he did that, and it worked out great for us. So, I mean, it got us 8 or 9 spots there that we probably shouldn't have if it was an all-out race. So, we're in the 30 car. We're in the AccuDoc 30 car this weekend. I look forward to running that car. Our buddy Harry Scott that's with AccuDoc always comes along and sponsors us. He's a good friend to the race team and a good friend of all of ours for the last few years. So it's almost his home track, so we look forward to running good there.
Well, and obviously it's a challenging track in Darlington, but I know you've told us before it's a racetrack that you actually like running at.
Yeah, we run really well there, and I think I ran fourth. Last maybe fourth or fifth, ran second the year before. It's a good place to turn our performances around. You know, the way the Nationwide point standings are, we're sitting great in points. So once we get our cars running a little better and we get a little more performance out of it, you know, it's going to turn into a great season. So, yeah, I enjoy Darlington. I mean, you run right on the fence down to 1 and 2, and turn two is it can be a dangerous place if you put a foot wrong there. It can jump out there and bite you. And then 3 and 4 is fun because there's almost 2 grooves in 3 and 4, and you can kind of pick your way through there. But it's just a cool racetrack. It's really, really neat. With all the history there and the shape of it and the uniqueness of it. And I don't know. I just like running right on the fence. It reminds me a lot of running Eldora in those places.
Well, how about running Darlington this weekend? We talk about how tough that track is. First of all, how long did it take you when you first got there to get the courage enough to bury the throttle, drop the hammer, and race about 3 inches off the wall there?
Well, it was tough, you know. I mean, it wasn't a deal. I think you have two different types of drivers. You got some that maybe are there and that are intimidated by the place, and other guys just show up and knock the right side off 3 or 4 times before they figure it out, and that was me. I couldn't go around that place without knocking the fenders in and getting the old Darlington stripe. So once I figured out how to slow down a little bit, it turned into a great racetrack. But it used to be the way the surface was and the tires wore out. I mean, it is a handful. And you can be cruising along there and think you have everything under control, and then, bam, place will jump out and get you. That's why they call it the Lady in Black.
Outside of reinforcing the right side, what else can you do to the race car to make it run well at Darlington?
I mean, it's like, any other racetrack. It just, there's nothing particular to make it go faster. But, yeah, you do kind of reinforce the right side, and because you will get the fence eventually. That's what I used to watch Jeff Gordon and Dale Jarrett and those guys. They win the Southern 500, and they wouldn't even have a scratch on the car, and it just was unbelievable. It showed you how good the drivers they are, and especially then with the, that was before the new surface. So yeah, I mean, it's just a unique racetrack, and you got to be committed there as a driver.
Now, what does that mean? Be committed.
You mean, well, I mean, like when we unload, you'll be probably, when you get into turn one, you got to be committed to picking the fence up early, picking the wall up early, because you have a tendency to pull down and then drive to the fence, but the sooner you get to the fence, usually the faster you are. So you got to be ready to make that commitment.
The way I see some of these guys drive, Bagman, they should all be committed for crying out loud.
I was going to say, if that car doesn't run white, right, you will be committed after the end of the race.
Yeah, that's true.
Hey, well, we appreciate the time. Thanks for checking in. We hear Charlie in the background. We'll let you spend some time with him. And we'll look forward to seeing you in the 30 car this weekend at Darlington. Back to the old 3-0, huh?
3-0, AccuDoc Special, yep.